Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, for today's video, I'm going to be using the Spike Factory in my pitter, right? So this is going to be insanely hard, but let's try to catch a dub with it. All right, boys, we're on the map in the wall. This is not the most optimal map for this strategy, right? I just need to grind XP for this tower, man. Being limited to tier 2 upgrades, it's not the move, right? It's definitely not the move. Honestly, like, kicking myself out of the Moab pit intentionally would not be that bad of an idea, right? Because everybody up here is good at this game. And two, they use the same stack strategies over and over. So, you know, it kind of gets repetitive, and I kind of want to see something new. Also, probably too, I'm just like making that up as an excuse because I am getting absolutely slapped by some of these players, man. Like, holy crap. These players are really, really goaded, but dude, like, these meta towers, man, they're just so good. They're literally just so good, boys, all right? But we can win this, all right? Like, we can't necessarily, like, we definitely won't have as good of a strategy compared to his strategy. So we're gonna kind of just try to have to win based off rushing him first with like DDTs or something like that, all right? So I guess that will be the goal. There's really not gonna be an optimal Spike Factory position either on this map, but we'll see what we can do, all right? So he's going Tag Shooter and Obin. All right, so that's a good combo for sure, for sure. I need to switch up my hero, by the way, too. I always use Cyber Quincy, and I actually unlocked like everything for him. So I definitely should switch that up probably for the next video, right? So yeah, but once we have at least like a third tier upgrade for the Spike Factory, it will be much better. And I think I'm going to go Middle Path. So let me know what you guys think about that, because Middle Path is the Moab Spikes upgrade, and that could actually help us out against DDTs and just Moab class balloons in general, right? So like a map like Dino Graveyard, I think it's called, we could set down Spike Factories in the back of the map so they can pile up all the spikes. And on round 26, if my opponent wants to send me a DDT, that should be able to handle, correct? At least I think. So hopefully that is the case, okay? But round 3 is here. We're now sending this guy a ton of blues, right? And he's already got the 203 Tag Shooter up, right? So this is the same gameplay that we've been seeing over and over. Everybody starts out the Tag Shooter, man. Okay, he sent me greens. Was that really necessary? If he sends me yellows, then I'm probably going to end up going for the 203 upgrader, right? Because I think if we don't, then the yellows will get by, right? But if we do, they should not, okay? But this map is like kind of hard to defend against honor, right? So honestly, round 26 DDTs might be the move, ladies and gentlemen, right? It depends on what his other towers are at the same time too. And also too, Obin's ability is actually nuts. It's literally nuts, and it literally disintegrates DDTs from what I've seen, right? So gonna kind of have to watch out for that. He's sending us freaking space whites, man. I think the 203 were absolutely chilling. Yeah, we are. Wow. You and your space eco, bro. You just need a max eco, dog. He wants that first blood so badly. I wouldn't really worry too much about the first blood, guys. Like, it's really not the end of the world if your opponent gets it or not. So if you leak a life, you leak a life, all right? It happens. It's all good, okay? But I mean, with a tax shooter, it's like kind of easy to avoid that though. So yeah, and like everybody starts out the tax shooter. Let's be real, okay? There's been very few times where I've seen my opponent start off with something other than the tax shooter. It's actually nuts. Tack needs to be nerfed, okay? But round 7 is about to be here, okay? So I'm gonna probably end up then going for another tax shooter next to this current one, okay? So let's just do that. Awesome. And we're probably gonna have to go for another 203 if we want to be able to fully defend against yellows here on round 7, all right? But he's not going to be able to defend against yellows. Oh, okay. I sent yellows a little bit too early, but I think he's going to use Obin's ability to defend, if I'm not mistaken. So, yep. There he goes with Obin's ability. Dang, man. Obin's ability is just freaking OP, but oh, the yellows are starting to get through now. Uh-oh. There he goes for another tax shooter up there. Oh my god, he afforded that super quickly. That was actually nuts. And he's still sending cons and yellows. That was crazy, guys. Okay, but solid defend for sure. Well done. We could actually potentially win this game, by the way, too, during the mid-game rounds, all right? So that's a possibility, boys, all right? We did hit 900 eco, right? So I'm going to start now ecoing with blues to passively eco because I'm still building it up, but I'm being safe about it because I need to get up this reactor probably before round 10 starts, which we might just barely be able to afford. Because without this, we don't have any lead detection whatsoever, right? So, but normally I try to hit for 900 eco, and that normally does pretty good for me, right? By the way, reactor's really not all that good on this map, okay? So we're gonna kind of have to passively eco for a little bit, I think, because we might need an overdrive in order to defend against, like, round 16 ceramics, because, like, they're pretty OP, guys. They're actually really, really OP, okay? So he's gonna go for reactor there, right? Well done. We definitely have enough money in order to do so as well, right? So there we go for that. Awesome. I feel like this guy is going to be aggressive, dude. I really do. Dude, regen rainbows, by the way. Super OP. Super OP. Okay, so if he's max eco in here, That's good. That means he's not gonna have too much money, and I could potentially Bloom boost freaking Rambos, and he could die. Potentially. So, because he doesn't have an overdrive up right now. So he actually would struggle. Obin's ability, though, would probably shred, so we're gonna have to keep that into account, all right? I need the Spike Factory, too, by the way, on the map, okay? So I guess I'm just gonna go for it right here so we can gain some XP on it. Because this game could end here very, very soon, ladies and gentlemen. Let's start equaling with blues again, all right? Just to be ultra, ultra safe. We don't have Lead Detection, too, okay? So I'm just gonna go for that. And, yeah, we're gonna see what happens here, okay? So round 16, we can sense Rinks, okay? We're gonna have to keep that in mind. We still actually cannot, though, send Rainbows, okay? I think on round 14, though, we're actually gonna be able to do that, all right? So probably gonna end up doing that then. He's not gonna be liking that. How OP is Obin, though, gonna be for him? It can't be that OP. And, dude, he's been ecoing so hard at me, bro. He's literally been ecoing so hard. He cannot have that much money, I don't think. I truly don't think so, guys, all right? So I'm gonna end up sending him a few Rainbows here, right? And I think I'm gonna also Balloon Boost him. So let's try that. Oh, that looks kind of OP. Oh my god, Overdrive's nuts. No, wait. That's leaks, at least. Oh my god, he really did not want to leak right there. Jesus. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my... Oh my goodness. Regen Rainbows Balloon Boosted are still OP, right? Even with that overdrive, he was not able to fully defend, okay? And thank God I set down a 0-0 Spike Factory, right? At least we got... See, we still got 147 XP, 441. Okay, so wait, guys, quickly, let's go over to the Spike Factory. Okay, guys, so yes, we can upgrade, all right? But what path should I upgrade? That's the ultimate question. Spike Balls does a little bit more damage to Ceramic and Fortify Balloons. So that's good, but this does damage to Mob Class Balloons, which are DDTs, okay? So I guess we're gonna go middle path, all right? Because eventually, too, we can get up Spike Storm, which will be super, super OP. And eventually, too, we can upgrade this as well, okay? So, all right, boys, so we're on the map. Castle Ruins. Dude, I am so hyped for this. I'm literally so freaking hyped. Dude, we got a third tier upgrade on the Spike Factory. That's so awesome, okay? So, right start of round two, or, no, sorry, round one. We're gonna be sending him, obviously, constant reds, and then also going for a Tax Shooter here, okay? Which... yeah, I'm kind of copying a spot, but like, I mean, I always use a spot anyway, okay? So he's gonna give us like good luck. Thank you, my friend. I appreciate that. But dude, Spike Factory could actually be somewhat beneficial for us. Somewhat, okay? Unfortunately, like, we don't have like a good spot to like really necessarily like stack up spikes on the map. But I mean, I'm just happy that I got a third tier upgrade straight up. So that could help us out a lot. Also, too, no one's defending an A45 BAD, I don't think, on round 30, unless he's going village and bomb too, because tag village bomb, it's OP, man. It's really, really OP. If you just spam freaking mob maulers, man, like, you're gonna freaking shred literally everything, man. Like, it's crazy, okay? So I'm just gonna take those lives, man. Okay, we did it in the last game. I didn't realize I didn't upgrade fully to the 202. It's fine. It's fine, okay? I'm not gonna sweat it. Not gonna sweat it, okay? But I'm gonna probably, no, we can just show with this 202, okay? But look at him. He's over defending like crazy. He went for another tax shoot already, and he's still sending me reds. That's quite interesting, right? So I don't know. I'm a little nervous, but dude, mid-game rushes are actually somewhat viable. Like that regen rainbow rush, I did not expect that to kill him. That was crazy, bro. Balloon boosts are so OP compared to like battles one balloon boost, like, yeah, of course, like, it's a little bit OP, but nothing compared to this, bro. Absolutely nothing. And by the way, the balloon boost affects all balloons that are already like on the map as well. So you don't like necessarily need a balloon boost before sending your rush. You can send like a little bit of balloons and then balloon booster, right? Because those balloons will also be balloon boosted. That's a lot of balloon booster, right? So hopefully that all made sense. And by the way, I don't know if I stated this or not, but my voice, I think I lost a little bit, all right? I was streaming the past 3 days, all right? And yesterday's stream, it wasn't the greatest, bro. It was not the greatest at all. He's sending me space pigs. That is just rude. It's just rude, man, okay? But, oh, he already went for top path freaking tack? That's quite interesting, all right? I literally have yet to even upgrade top path or unlock it. I think I have enough XP for it. I just have yet to do so, all right? Because I also have tier 5 middle path, which is like the super maelstrom or whatever. That goes nuts, but I don't normally use that all that much, okay? But, dude, he's sending me whites. That is so rude. That is so rude, bro. Oh, my. Okay, so I'm probably then going to end up going for the attack shooter, I guess, like, right here, okay? So Quincy's going to be able to handle that. I already, like, leaked anyways. Like, he got the first blood, so, like, why is he doing that? I don't really know, right? But we get another attack shooter on standby for round 7 yellows, all right? And I think he's also going to be fine because, like, he's really been over-defending, man. for whatever reason, I feel like this guy is going to be aggressive towards us during the mid-game rounds, just like the last game. Although, I was their aggressor. But, like, dude, it's just so OP, man. It's so OP if you don't have a solid reactor spot. The reactor spot on this map is actually pretty solid, okay? So, I don't know. We'll see what happens, okay? But round 16 ceramics, bro. Balloon booster round 16 ceramics. They're OP. They're literally so OP, okay? So, we might end up sending those. We'll just have to wait and see, I guess, okay? But we also got to remember to set down at least a 0-0 spike battery, and then we'll be chilling, okay? Because I want to gain more XP, of course, for that. But, like, if possible, like, I want to go late game because I honestly want to see how these spike batteries would handle DDTs, okay? Because without Alk, dude, our attack shooters are probably going to be pretty weak, in my opinion. And then we can't get all that many first strikes up in this little pond of water, all right? So, I don't think we can defend against a fortified BAD. Like, we have, like, literally no chance, actually. So, if he sends us one first on round 30, I'll probably have to end up countering with DDTs, maybe, if he can't defend those, okay? But we have well over 1,000 eco. That's why I decided to now eco with these blues so that we can afford this reactor here, okay? So, I'm going to make sure that I get a really solid reactor spot, okay? So, it's going to be, like, right there, okay? Perfect, perfect, perfect. Start upgrading to that. And he's also got the sub, right? So, yeah. It's gonna be hard to win during the mid-game rounds. Yeah, he's using our strategy. Like, that's my main strategy. Tac sub Alk. It's so good. It's literally so freaking good, okay? But I want to eco a little bit harder here, okay? So I'm gonna start ecoing with yellows. We're gonna upgrade to reactor middle path as well so that we can pop lead balloons. Oh, we don't have enough money. We already ran out of money. That's actually crazy, okay? So reactor spot on this map compared to the last map, way better, okay? So, like, we should not struggle to a balloon boosted rush, but, like, also at the same time, like, you literally never know. Let's see how far these yellows get. See, like, they kind of get that. I don't know. The pinks, dude, that gets far, bro. Balloon boosted regen rainbows, that would be an issue. I'm telling y'all right now, that would actually be an issue. So we have to watch out for that, all right? What should I do here? Should I just go for a spike factory, I guess, like, right here? Yeah, that works, okay? So let's just do that. And I could afford an overdrive here as well, okay? So might just go for that just to be safe. He went for an overdrive and also an alchemist. So, like, yeah, I'm going to do that, okay? I'm going to do that because I'm scared. Balloon boosted freaking mid-game rush is ROP, but, like, with him having overdrive, he actually does not have a reactor, though. He does not have a reactor. So we could send like, a very quick rush. I kind of want to. Just to kind of scare him a little bit. Let's see how he reacts. I want to see how good, like, Alk Buff is, too. He boosted. Okay. We'll take that. We'll take that, boys. We'll take it. We'll take it, all right? So, let's see. Round 16 is about to be here. He could, in fact, send us regen ceramics, so we're going to have to watch out for that. So, maybe I should chill for a second. He's going to go for another texture or two. He's probably scared. Oh, my God, bro. Holy crap. Like, he was not messing around when it came to that, bro. Even with the alchemist buff as well. Like, that's crazy. Oh, he's sending me those. Okay. Please. Good. Oh my God. We disintegrated those. What? I got so scared, man. I didn't have enough money for another overdrive, though, right? So, that almost was bad, but I guess we shredded somehow. Okay, so definitely not complaining about that, all right? I don't think it's going to be necessarily worth it if we send him another rush, but, like, the fact that he did not go for reactor, what if he doesn't have four-tier middle path sub? That means he wouldn't have first strike. So that is something that we should consider, all right? Because fortified ZOMG possibly could be pretty OP and effective towards him, okay? So might just end up doing that, all right? But I'm going to get back to max sequin, and I might go for another overdrive. Like, without Alk buffs, bro, like, I'm just scared. Because, like, the tax shooter, it's good still, but, like, I don't know. It's not as good, you know? So, like, I get nervous. So, yeah. I just went for another overdrive just to be ultra safe. And I probably should utilize the spike factory a little bit more, right? So, yeah. We're going to end up doing that. Dude, no, oh my God. A spike factory spot down here would be goated. So, yeah. I'm going to do that. I'm going to go for a spike factory spot right here, okay? And we'll upgrade, obviously, middle path and then top path, okay? Moab Shredder, bro. I'm so hyped. I'm freaking hyped, boys. But it's now round 18, okay? So, he could also send us a Moab, which, that would be kind of backwards. I feel like a single Moab is just, like, too easy to defend. So, yeah. Also, a single BFB as well. So, he most likely won't be doing that. But a fortified ZOMG could potentially be bad for him. Although, he could still have the first strike ability. Okay, so we're going to have to watch out for that. But I'm going to go for this top path upgrade, all right? And then, yeah, we can actually go for middle path as well. Dude, the 2-3 Moab Shredder Spike Factory, right? I'm so hyped about it, bro. I'm so hyped because, like, Spike Factory is my favorite tower, right? And we're finally, like, trying out something new. Like, I went down and, like, actually, I've lost 4 trophies, man. That sucks, bro. I lost 4 trophies, but, like, I think it was worth it, all right? Because at least I'm, like, I'm trying something new. Because, like, doing the same strategy over and over, man, it gets, obviously, super repetitive, all right? So, Let's see how we can defend, though, against this mob. We should be absolutely chilling, I think, with two overdrives and also this third tier. Oh, yeah. Disintegrated that. Let's freaking go, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so round 26, though, DDTs could be an issue. I'm probably going to have to upgrade to the attack zone if I want to have a chance of defending, okay? We also, though, like, I wonder how good this would do against a single DDT. Like, would it shred? Because it has lead detection, has camo detection technically as well. Oh, he was leaking lives to the AI, I think. Why is he not going for reactor, bro? He definitely should. I don't know why. Like, oh, he already went for tag zone? Oh my god. That's really early. I normally like to like try to hide the fact that I have tag zone, but like we are in Moab Pit, so I guess most people assume that I have tier fives. But man, oh man, that was like pretty early. Okay, so I'm gonna go for another spike factory. I guess like right over here. I kind of like this spot over here. So there we go with that. All right. Once again, 2-3-0 spike factory. All right. Those could potentially shred DDTs, bro. They could, in fact. So I'm hyped to see how that works out for us. All right. Dude, I don't know. DDTs on round 32 definitely would be pretty OP. All right. Because like, I don't know if I want to send him a 4-5 BAD. Like, that's quite a bit of money. And he might just counter with DDTs. I don't know, man. Like, it's just scary, bro. DDTs are so unbelievably good. But, like, if we had spike stores, man, like, I think we'd be chilling. I would be so much more confident that we could defend against DDTs. Like, dude, because it just shreds. So, this, I'm so happy I'm grinding for this. Very, very happy. And I feel like this, like, tower can actually be a lot more useful now that we have a third tier upgrade as well, right? But he's going for more subs in there. So, that leads me to believe that he has first strike ability. He's got to have first strike. He literally has got to. Okay, so I'm sending down a lot of spike factories, like down near this reactor, okay? And that means, so if he sends me like a DDT, we're gonna see like how the spike factories handle it at first, okay? But I'm still gonna go for tax zone. 100% still gonna go for that, all right? So that is not out of the question. Oh, is that sub commander? That's bottom path, yeah. So he does not have first strike. Interesting. Dude, like what the heck, bro? Oh, we're struggling to AI leads, bro. No, we're chilling. We're chilling, boys. So I'm gonna go for another overdrive, by the way, okay? Because, like, I want to use the spike factory, but, like, we need some overdrives at the same time. So, yeah, I feel like this is pretty smart for us to do. And what do we got? $33,000. Okay, we got 5,000 eco, so, like, we're actually chilling right now, I think. I think we are. We could go for another spike factory, though. Like, I just love the spike factory, man. I just love it. So there we go for another one. That's more towards, like, the back of the map. He's not ecoing at us currently. He is not ecoing at us. Okay, so he's gonna send DDT. He has to send DDT. He has to. He's facepalming us. What? Why is he not sending anything? Dude, I thought for sure he's gonna be sending DDT. This is why I don't like to reveal fit to your tax zone just yet. Because I feel like it inclines my opponent sometimes to send DDTs on round 26. But he still has yet to. I feel like he would shred, so I'm not even gonna do that. Look how many alchemists he has. Yeah, like he would shred easily a single DDT. So he might send one you can send three DDTs. I don't know what round that is. I think that's round 28 possibly. So he's probably gonna do that. Guys, okay, I'm just gonna go for it then. I'm gonna go for attack zone now. Like, it doesn't matter at this point. And I'm gonna go for more overdrives because, like, I really feel like he's going to be sending me something. So might as well just upgrade these defenses so that we have a little bit of a better chance of defending, you know? Because, man, oh man, I've got some money. I could go for first strike two down here as well. So I might, in fact, do that. So yeah, I'm gonna try to do that. Oh my God, I can't, like, get any more subs. Well, yeah, I can. Yes, I can. Okay, so I think we're chilling, boys. Like, he's really saving up money. I don't think he can defend 4-5 DDTs. With tower boost, he can. But on round 32, like, we can send a few DDTs at first, and then after he tower boost and it goes away, we can send more DDTs, and he's done, I think. Hopefully. Because that might just be the move. But he might also rush us. So, like, decisions, man. I'm nervous, bro. Whether we win or lose, though, I'm going to be happy with this performance, all right? Because we're actually utilizing the spike factory quite a bit. So, like, that is just awesome to see, okay? So, yeah, going for these subs, first strikes, two first strikes, having those on standby, like, that's actually going to help us out quite a bit. I guess I'll go for another tax shooter here instead of that spike factory, okay? And I want to make sure that I have a decent amount of money saved up, okay? So, we have 29,000. I probably should just full-on stop ecoing, too. Like, he has not been ecoing, guys. He has not been ecoing whatsoever. So, I think what I'm going to do is send him fortified DDTs right at the start of round 30, try to bait that tower boost, and then once it wears off, I'm definitely going to be countering him, probably selling tax on this so that we can get a little bit more money, and balloon boosting another rush at him, okay? So, yeah. Oh, I accidentally sent a BAD. Okay, I swear to God, I did not mean to do that, but I guess that's fine, okay? So, we're going to send that. All right, he definitely sent it first, so like that's kind of unfortunate, right? So I'm just gonna send some DDTs then. Hopefully that baits boost. Yes, it did. Let's go. Okay, so he boosted to that. That's really, really good. That's really, really good. Okay, so I'm gonna sell Attack Zone here and then send another rush here in a second, okay? Because I feel like that is probably the play. He's dead first. He's dead first, right? He's dead first. 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 Oh my god, that's stalling. Oh no, I died first. Oh my god, Al freaking stalled those balloons. I didn't think that was gonna happen. That single-handedly won him the game, bro. Oh my god, Alk is so OP, man. But like I said, guys, I did not want to constantly use the Alchemist. It's fine, okay? That was actually a really, really good game. And finally, we had the third tier Spike Factory, okay? So like, I can't be mad. There was no chance, even with Tower Boost, we wouldn't defend it, okay? So like, that's why I didn't even think to defend, or Tower Boost, I mean. But that's a fact, going to be a GG. And also wrapping up today's video, I hope you guys did enjoy. Let me know what you guys thought about the Spike Factory down in the comments below. But I'm going to be streaming later tonight if you want to join that, all right? And also, I'm going to be posting again tomorrow, okay? So hope you guys did enjoy once again. It's been your boy, Voltrix, or Justin. Peace out, everybody.